Hey everybody, Mike Iaconelli. Want to talk to you about Going Ike Season 3 San Diego kayak fishing episode. Man, what a blast. Got to fish with a good friend of mine, Morgan, out of my Hobie kayak, and got to fish in the saltwater for a change. Caught a lot of species on this trip, including halibut, sheep's head, and the hard-fighting bonita. Want to talk to you a little bit about some of the key equipment in this particular episode. Let me start with the bait, and then I'll go to the rod and the reel and the line. The bait for this show is one of my favorites in both fresh and salt water, and it is a jigging spoon. A jigging spoon's awesome because it imitates bait fish perfectly. You can fish it a lot of different ways, from burning it on top and skipping it to deep jigging it in 40, 50, 60, 70 feet of water, even swimming it like a crankbait. And I used in this show a spoon by Mullix called a Juggalo. And I used the 3/4 ounce size, basically in a color that sort of looked like, an anchovy. Style of bait fish they have on the West Coast. And it was really, really key. The great thing about it is I made super long casts to fish that I would see feeding on the surface. And those bonita would hit like a ton of bricks. The fight lasted 5 or 10 minutes each fish. Amazing fight for a freshwater guy that's used to catching little bass. The rod and reel, real important, because when I'm kayak fishing, I love this particular setup and I want to talk to you about it. It's a long spinning rod. It's a 7'6" Abu Garcia medium heavy action spinning rod. So really longer spinning rod than normal that I could take that heavier spoon and make super, super long cast. The other thing about that long spinning rod is when you're sitting down in a kayak, that longer Abu Garcia Ike Series rod helps you get the leverage. On the reel, I used a 30-sized Abu Garcia Ike Series reel, brand new reel. And then the line was real important too. And I used braid to a fluoro-leader. And I went with 20-pound spider wire ultra cast braided line to about a 2-foot leader of 25-pound Berkeley Trilene, 100% fluorocarbon. Even on those big sheephead and halibut, this line allowed me to land those really big fish. You know, I want to talk to you finally about two other really key components in this chute. And one is the pedal drive system on a Hobie kayak. You know, kayak fishing's awesome, but I love the kayaks that are hands-free. And this is the 360 Mirage Drive from Hobie, and it allows you simply by pulling a lever to go forward or backward, and then of course all with your feet, leaving both your hands free to catch those fish. And then finally, really key to this chute was having a depth finder on my kayak, but I needed one that was up high and I could see it so I could find the bait, find those changes. And this is a ram mount that fits perfectly right on the H rail on my Hobie kayak. I was able to put my Lowrance Elite 7 on there, get a great view right there in my face, know how deep to jig that spoon. It was the perfect complement to a great day of fishing. Let me tell you something. I hope you enjoyed episode 1, Going Ike Season 3, kayak fishing in San Diego. Try some of that stuff. Whatever you're fishing for, and I bet you're gonna have some luck. See you later.